beside her, she is ordering a drink. She says, oh, Julie says hi and asks about her boy. She says he's fine and there's a pause. She says it's funny that you ask. Today I had a strange experience.
Yes. I sit back and watch TV. Of all the faces on the screen, I have seen none of me. Staggeringly, the melting ice caps in my dream made me stop and think about time running out. I would quit my job if I had.
should I long for you now, even when you just leave the room? Of all the roads and the cities that I passed through, all the eyes I have searched inside, the one sense of permanence that I came to feel is mine.
Just a minute away, I'd be knocking on your front door. Don't underestimate this precious time. Every second is treated as though there is no time. Your eyes are wider than before. So little has changed, but your eyes now see much more. Hush, now sway and fall asleep. Gonna drive you away from the trembling of bustling feet.
packed all we need to make this come true. We'll deepen this river, the stories they lie, and hear them
I wanna talk about anything. I wanna kiss your lips again. Hello, everybody. I'm just going to jump on the mic just because I do have a live stream as well as this in-person show tonight. Thank you for coming. This would be my second hybrid show of this year, so you're all very cutting edge, and thank you. And I just wanted to acknowledge that we're on the unceded territory of the Lekwungen and Songhees First Nations, and that we acknowledge that we live, work, and play here, and we're very grateful. And I want to say hi to people that are on the live stream. So tonight, this would have been a show where Hey Fitz and Jacob Miller were performing, and I hosted Hey Fitz in January of 2020 in my living room, and some people here tonight were there. I know. And it was a really great, special little moment, an emotional moment. So I think Jacob, or Brandon's in that live stream, and hopefully you're hearing me because I'll be back checking the audio in a second. But I'm glad that you can be here virtually. That's something. And that's the benefit of some things we lived through in the pandemic. So I'd like to welcome to the stage Jacob Miller, who's from Portland, Oregon, born in Wisconsin. And so far we had a great time. I picked him up from the ferry, and we went for lunch at the Roost, and had to drive through town and picked up gear and went along the ocean. So it was really fun just to get to know an artist from somewhere who has never been ever here or played a show here. So you guys are the first. You heard it here first. All right, so let's get started.
Well, thank you. Thanks for being here. Best if I just play along. I like your spells that last a while longer than they should. I'm a masochist, I need your siren song. Loving you is easy, living's just the same. It's when you're not around, I feel the pain. Yeah, know that when you need me, all you have to say, all you have to say. Baby, maybe you can come around by me tonight. Baby, maybe you could wrap your arms around. Tricks on me tonight. Whoa, oh, oh, I can smell the coffee beans brewed up this morn. I can feel the weight of your skin. Stay up late. Then I know the moon can afford, but those waking hours just feel so fleeting. Loving you is easy, and living's just the same. It's when you're not around, I feel the pain. That when you need me, all you have to say, all you have to say. Baby, maybe you can come around by me tonight. arms around me a little too tight. The battle looks bigger in the frying pan, too white. Baby, maybe you can play your tricks on me tonight. Whoa, oh, baby, maybe you can play your tricks on me. Thank y'all so much for being here. Yeah, my name's Jacob Miller, and I'm coming from Portland, Oregon. I've been traveling with my buddy Hayfitz until, unfortunately, just 2 days ago when he wasn't able to come up to Canada. So really happy to be here. Victoria's so lovely. I've been here for, I think, about like 6 hours, and it's been a very impressive 6 hours. So anyways, I'm going to play a lot of original music and a couple covers, and we're just going to kind of hang out. So thank you guys again for being here. This next song, that was a tune of mine called Tricks that I just played. I wrote it while I was doing artist residency in the Deschutes National Forest in Oregon. I live in Portland, as I mentioned. And this next song I'm going to play, it's off my first record. It's called Lifted. And this tune is about being intentional with the people you love. And I think it's really easy to make excuses for the people and things that matter in the modern digital age when we're constantly being told like a notification that we need our attention on or something. And so this tune's just about, yeah, spending a day with someone you care about. Let's go get lifted. We can drive to the park. You can talk about your high school stories, baby. We don't have to go far. Let's take the day off. We deserve some reprieve. Can't remember the last time you and I shared a laugh over a drink. And I know that you're struggling to find the time. We can go leave this all backyard, a bottle of whiskey, a story, one cigarette. We don't need too much to get right back to how things were. I'm just yearning to strike this old matchbox and watch our dancing flame burn. And I know that you're struggling to find the time. But we can go leave this all behind.
Yeah, so I released a record that you can see there. I had to smuggle it over the border, so don't tell border control. But yeah, I released this record in March of this year, and just with the pandemic, I did a lot of touring, a lot of heavy touring in 2019, and I was it was kind of a crazy year leading up the pandemic. I did about 8 months of touring, and then I was on a show, The Voice, on NBC for a couple months, and then it kind of just all plateaued, and then the pandemic happened, and so it was a very interesting last couple of years. And I recorded this record right after I got off the show in early spring of 2020. And I really didn't want to really release the record until I was able to tour and share the songs with people in person, because I really like that kind of exchange. And so I'm going to do the title track next off of this record. It's called Around My Head. And this song is kind of just little fragments of notes and love letters that I wrote my friends and people while I was on the road touring a lot in that year. And yeah, it's called Around My Head. I ask myself the question, but I do not know the answer, so I keep my mouth shut and continue guessing. But the moons and the magnets that keep our world up and down keep these 2 feet to the ground, to rest and to fight. Dodge the darkness as it flies around me now, around my head, around my head, around my head, around my head, around my head. The tour so far has been fun. This is the last show of the tour, actually, before we kind of conclude things. And I'm going to catch the ferry tomorrow and head to Bellingham for a short period. And then I'm going to the San Juan Islands to do an artist residency for about a week and a half on Orcas Island. And I've been really fortunate enough to go there the last couple summers and do this residency where I kind of stay in a cabin and just write for about a week, which is really nice. And it's a nice kind of decompression after, like, moving every day very chaotically. And yeah, but this trip's been really lovely. As I said, this is my first time in this area, and traveling with Brandon was really fun. We had never actually hung out before. We met at a show I played in Brooklyn last December, and then we kind of planned this tour after I met him, and we got in the car in LA and drove for like 5 hours, and I was like, thank God he's a nice guy. So really worked out for the best. So I'm going to play a brand new tune. I played it for the first time for an audience in Seattle, and it's about my pop, and it's kind of a emotional tune, but I played it on the porch in Seattle the night before the gig, and Brandon encouraged me to share it. And the last two nights I've shared it, a couple people have come up and said that they connected with it, so I figure I'll keep this emotional train running and play this tune. It's called Midwest Hospitality, which can mean a lot of different things depending on who you're talking to.
The game as if I care, a capitalistic family affair. You pour the drinks, ask how I've been. To be honest, didn't think that I would visit again. After you push the chair and threw down your keys, said kiss my ass, and I asked you to leave. For someone so tough, you're so naive. Is that what you call Midwest hospitality? Or do you do as you please? Not much is all right, but Susan bought me tickets for a 12 a.m. flight. The numbers don't lie, he shows me his den. Kicks my ass at billiards, now he calls me his friend. You held my hand in the car the whole ride. Missed me more than I could realize. For someone so tough, you're so naive. Is that what you call Midwest hospitality? Or do you do as you please?
Pretty big Paul Simon fan. We got any Paul Simon fans in the house? All right, cool. I will take that smile and nod as a yes. Yeah, I read his biography last year, and really such an interesting career he had. And I'm just such a fan of his songwriting. I feel like he writes in a way that is so specific to his own experience, but somehow is so universally relatable to the listener. And I really try to take notes when I listen to his stuff. But I'm going to play a tune of his called Kodachrome, which is kind of like a quintessential summer song for a lot of people. So
when I think back on all the crap I learned in high school, it's a wonder I can think it all. And though my lack of education hasn't hurt me none, I can read the writing on the wall. Kodachrome. give us the nice bright colors, give us the greens of summer, make you think all the world's a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got a Nikon camera, I love to take the photograph. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome away. If you took all the girls I knew when I was single, brought them all together for one night, no, it never matched my sweet imagination. Plus everything looks worse in black and white. Kodachrome, give us the nice bright colors, give us the greens of summer, make you think all the world's a sunny day. Oh yeah, I got a Nikon camera, I love to take the photograph. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome away. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome. Leave those boys far from home. Mama, don't take my Kodachrome away.
Round of applause for the Victoria House for having us. Thank you so much. My pleasure. I'm glad it all worked out. It's really nice to be here, and what a lovely setting, like the sunflowers and the sky. You guys should turn around occasionally during my set. It's pretty nice. I've got my fingers crossed. I guess a little more about myself. As I mentioned, I live in Portland, Oregon. I've been there for about 13 years. I moved from a really small town in Wisconsin in the Midwest. It's called Eden. It's about 500 people. I lived there for most of my life before I moved west. And when I moved to Portland, I was doing a lot of like busking and playing on the street. And I met a lot of songwriters and good friends of mine now. And I led a 7-piece jazz band for about 7 years. And we did kind of turn of the century swing and blues, ragtime and jazz. And the last 5 years or so, I've been doing my solo singer-songwriter stuff. And it's been really cool. This is my favorite kind of setting, is to share space with people such as yourself in beautiful places. So thank you again for joining and not really knowing what you're getting into, I guess. So. I'm going to play the first track off my new record. It's called Leave, and this song shares a theme, as I mentioned, I write about quite a lot, which is being intentional with the people you love and the time that we have, which is less than you think, I guess. And this song specifically is about just taking a drive to the coast with your loved one for no apparent reason. Thank you.
We took a trip to the shoreline. Drive from the city to get away. Coastal towns and freight trains roll by with the day. With the day.
The band's here.
We didn't pack bags, we just had to get away. From the sounds and from the screen. Oh, I wanna go, oh, babe. I wanna go, oh, babe. I wanna leave. I wanna leave. Let me take you for a ride. Cheap diner, smoke outside. We've no particular place to be. We can drive into the night. Take a walk on the wild side. It's you.
Everything sounding okay to you guys? Is all right, great, super. Great. Oh yeah, next month or something? Or when is it? In October, that's right, yeah. Well, I'll have to check them out. Yeah. All right, so far, success all around. Oh yeah, live stream. How are you guys doing? I won't know until after the next song, but let us know. We're all in this together. Am I? I'm great, yeah, I'm good. I got a long sleeve on under this, so thanks for asking. It's actually really thoughtful. Yeah, I didn't know what to expect, so that's why I brought the double denim, so. It is, yeah, but Portland's like been getting hotter and hotter every year. It's insane. Just 2 weeks ago, we had a 100-degree week, just straight, which it's usually so cool and, you know, pretty temperate. And the winters, you know, are really, that's why I moved from Wisconsin, or at least part of the reason, so. But yeah, it was actually interesting. I think it was it last year in Portland, we had a week where it was like 115 one day, and it was like literally hotter than Death Valley in Portland, Oregon. I think it was like the hottest place. It was really weird, but I was on the San Juan Islands actually that week, so I was really lucky, but it was 92 degrees on island, which is like unheard of, so it was, what a world we live in. But I'm gonna play a new tune. I wrote this just about two or three weeks ago, I guess. I do these songwriting challenges with my friends. As I mentioned, I've got a lot of touring and songwriting friends back in Portland. And a nice kind of, if you're in a rut or having a hard time being creative, a couple of my friends do this thing called the 7-Day Songwriting Challenge. And every day for 7 days, you write a new song with no old ideas, no cheating. And I've got a big cowboy hat, and we write a bunch of prompts, and I pick a prompt every morning from the hat, and I text the group chat, and I say, hey, today's prompt is, you know, such and such. And so I say it's a great excuse to write 7 awful songs. But usually you write 1 or 2 decent ones, and so hopefully you think that about this next song. Yeah. It's called Stay High With You. The hat on this day was, or the prompt was, pick a substance and write a song about your experience being under the influence of that substance. So, very kid-friendly stuff. They're usually not that bad, but some of them are actually way worse, but, you know, every day's different, so. I forgot what I was gonna say. It probably doesn't matter anyway. It's funny how in life things come and go. Clouds that look like creatures, life's little woes. And I don't need to drown my fears. Cocaine, pills, or beer. I just need you by my side. We'll go on a little ride. Let's get high. It gets me by. Can't help but wonder why we're here. The cosmos tends to leave me feel inferior. Constantly humbled by the songs it sings. The daylight dancing round you and the joy you bring. I like to lay my worries down.
fancy if you'd like to come around. I just need you by my side. We'll go on a little ride. Let's get high. It gets me by. It's true. Stay high with you. It's true. I wanna stay high with you.
Yeah, as I mentioned, I did a jazz band for a long time. I really love turn of the century, kind of like old American jazz music. When I moved to Portland when I was 19, I moved into a house. Funny enough, actually, everyone in the house I met, everyone from Craigslist, and they were all from Wisconsin. Like, there was like four people, including our downstairs neighbors, were all from Wisconsin. Very random. But all the kids, they were about 20, I guess. All the kids that I lived with were all like hitchhiking, like bluegrass or roots musicians, and one of them was a ragtime guitarist, so he'd take like 1910s and 20s piano ragtime pieces and transcribe them to guitar. And let me tell you, it's some pretty nerdy stuff, very nerdy stuff. And I really fell into the well, so to speak. I got really, really into this old music. And then I started this jug band and blues band that turned into a swing jazz band. And yeah, it's really cool. Just all of that music, obviously, it's not as popular anymore. But when you start diving into it, there's just such an infinite well of this music because there's so many lost recordings and, yeah, really cool stuff. And so I started getting into that music and really enjoyed it. It still definitely influences the songs that I write now and the music that I enjoy. But I was playing in that band for quite a while, and I have both my grandparents on my mother's side passed before I was born. And I didn't really know a lot about them, but I knew my grandfather was a piano player. And I came back home to play a gig years ago, and I was told by my aunt that a little bit more about my grandfather, James, and him and my grandmother, Jean, would write songs together. And they really enjoyed singing, and he'd play piano, and they'd both sing together, and they wrote quite a few pieces. And so I was shown this song. It's called Two Sleepy People. It's a Hoagy Carmichael song from the late 1920s. I actually haven't played it in a really long time, but I thought tonight might be a cool night to share with you guys. But I heard my friend Leon play this song. He's a really talented saxophone and keyboardist. And I was like, wow, I've never heard that old tune. That's such an obscure song. And he showed it to me, and I learned my own version of it. And I went back home for a gig and played, and my aunt told me, oh, that was your grandma Jean's favorite song to sing with James when they would play together. And so the song kind of took on new meaning, and I always thought it was just a lovely tune, and now it means quite a bit more to me. So it's called Two Sleepy People. Here we are, out of cigarettes, holding hands and yawning, see how late it gets. Two sleepy people by dawn's early light, too much in love to say goodnight. Here we are, in the cozy chair, picking on a wishbone in the frigid air. Two sleepy people with nothing to say, too much in love to fade away. Do you remember the nights when we would linger in the hall? Your father didn't like me at all. You remember the reason why we married in the fall? To get a little rest, to make a little nest. Oh,
are just about the same. Sleepy little fella, drowsy little dame. Two sleepy people with nothing to say. Too much in love to fade away.
What was that? All right, great. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can play another one. Sure, yeah, actually. Why not? What time is it? I'll do a couple originals, and then I'll circle back with a jazz song, just for you. This tune I wrote during the height of the pandemic. It's called Get Your Love, and I would argue it's probably not, at this point in all of our lives, the first quarantine love song you've heard. But prove me wrong.
I got something to tell you. I've got something to say. I try but become tongue-tied around some people. I've only had one drink but I'm in a daze, hearing every other word. My head up in the clouds, running in circles, but I'm determined to be part of your life somehow. Come and get your love. Come and get your love. Get your love. Come and get your love. I have placed myself in a quarantine. The radio keeps fine company. I strum the dusty strings, hoping something drapes over me, like the gentle curtain that is your voice. Guess I'm just killing time, watching from inside, counting the days till I can open the door and try to make you mine. Come and get your love.
See that hummingbird? That was pretty neat. I got pretty distracted, to be honest with you. I love that. I've hit my head on that like 5 times since I've been here, so I'm glad like there's a payoff for sure. Cool. I've got like, what was that? Yeah, the humming. I don't know if he's in tune. We should tune together. Yeah, we got probably like 4 more songs or so. So thank you guys so much for hanging out and just listening. I'm going to do another Paul Simon tune. This is one of my favorite songs of all time. It's called Something So Right, and this is off his second solo record, There Goes Rhymin' Simon, arguably his best record, in my opinion at least. But I love this song, and one really cool thing that Paul Simon does with his music when he releases it digitally is he includes a lot of like demos of the tunes that we all know well. And it's cool to see like the blueprints of songs that are such, I don't know, so impactful to so many people. And a lot of them have different storylines and different melodies and different names, but they, you know, eventually got to this place where, like Kodachrome, for example, or this next one I'm going to play. But yeah, this next one I'm going to play, it's off his second solo record. It's called Something So Right. And on the digital album that he released, there's a version or a demo version of this tune called Let Me Live in Your City. And it just amazes me that that song is so beautiful, Let Me Live in Your City. I definitely recommend if you got a streaming service that you check out that album, There Goes Rhymin' Simon, Let Me Live in Your City. It's the earlier version of this tune I'm about to play. And it just amazes me that someone could write a song that pretty and then be like, nah, I'm going to redo the whole thing. Kind of incredible. So, yeah, Something So Right.
The cool water when the fever runs high. You've got the look of love light in your eye. I was in crazy motion till you calmed me down. Took a little time, but you calmed me down.
Got another creature.
When something goes wrong, I'm the first to admit it. The first to admit it, but the last one to know. Something goes right, well, it's likely to lose me. it's apt to confuse me, 'cause it's such an unusual sight. Oh, I know I can't get used to something so right, something so right. They got a wall in China, it's 1,000 miles long. To keep out foreigners, they built it strong. I've got a wall around me, you can't even see. Took a little time to get next to me. When something goes wrong, ooh, the first to admit it, but the last one to know. Something goes right, well, it's likely to lose me. Have to confuse me, 'cause it's such an unusual sight. But now I'm sure I can't get used to something so right, something so right. Some people don't say the words "I love you," it's not their style. Oh, to be so bold. Some people never say those words, "I love you." Like a child, they're longing to be told. Something goes wrong. I'm the first to admit it. Last one to know. Something goes right, well, it's likely to lose me. Yeah, it's apt to confuse me, such an unusual sight. But now I know I can't get used to something so right.
Lovely. Well, I'm just going to play a couple more. You guys have been such a nice audience. Thanks for listening. And, you know, sometimes people talk, and that works too, but it's so much nicer for me when people listen. So, yeah, and if anyone's got good seafood wrecks tomorrow, I'm going to go downtown and try to soak up the town while I'm here before I catch the ferry across. So, yeah, let me know. Also, I've got a couple records for sale. And if you guys, you know, don't want to buy a record, feel free to follow me online. You can find just Jacob Miller, search on social media and all that good stuff, and on the usual streaming services. So if you do like what you hear, please check it out. Follow me. It does actually help quite a lot. So thank you. I'm going to play a jazz tune. I'm going to play an old jazz tune. This is one of my favorites. It's actually really quite a popular fingerstyle song. So as I got into the ragtime music from transcribing old jazz songs, it's kind of funny. They're in the late 1960s, early 70s, mid 70s. There was quite a almost like renaissance of ragtime guitarists. A lot of dudes with goofy names: Duck Baker, Mary Flower, Stephen Grossman. Stephen Grossman was kind of at the helm. He started this record label called Kicking Mule, and these guys would get together and play these really complicated jazz tunes and melodies with all these walking bass lines. And I kind of dove into that well, too. And this song I'm going to play next is called I'll See You in My Dreams. And I believe it was written for a musical in the early 1930s, but it's always been one that I really enjoyed playing. It's got a really fun melody. It's really fun to just pick around on. So here it is. I'll See You in My Dreams. Two songs left, I think I'll play. I'm going to do one original, and then I'll close with a cover, which is, I guess pretty jazzy as well. This tune I'm going to play next, the original, it's called Monologue, and I wrote this about a year and a half ago when I was having some pretty difficult conversations with family members. And it was definitely a moment of realizing that listening comes in many different forms and is very important. And I wrote this song about listening, more specifically, listening not to wait your turn to talk, but to actually provide space for people. So when you are sharing space with them, you can deepen your own perspective and understanding about where they're coming from and hopefully learn something about yourself or maybe something you didn't even know. So really, it's a song about learning to shut up. It's called Monologue.
keep your thoughts to yourself, 'cause I'm tired of listening like a movie on TV that we're all enduring. It starts pretty strong, but I've seen it before, like an REO Speedwagon song. By the middle I start to get bored. Can you pick up a cue like your beer off the floor? Take a hint, shut your mouth. The world won't explode if you're not saying words out loud. Bite your tongue, or the room will be empty before your monologue. Done, done, done before your done, done, done. Remember Wisconsin. 95. We put the box under the bed the day that he died, and we all kept quiet. Maybe that's why you had a midlife crisis when you were 20. Dust off the box, now it lives at your side. Take a hint, shut your mouth. The world won't stop turning if you aren't so goddamn loud. Youngest son, the room will be empty before your monologue.
Close with a cover tune by Mr. Fred Rogers, aka Mr. Rogers. So I guess I've got a couple things I want to say about Mr. Rogers. Number one, he's great. Love him. When I was in high school, I used to have free period, and me and my drummer in my metal band, we were like a death metal band. We would go home on our lunch breaks and eat lunch together and watch Mr. Rogers, which is like the most anti-metal thing, I guess, ever. But I've got two sisters. I'm the baby of three, and they're my best friends. We talk every day on the phone or FaceTime. They live back in Wisconsin now, but for a short period, we all lived in Portland. We actually all lived in a house together with their partners, and it was very sitcom-style living. A lot of chaos ensued. But anyways, my middle sister, Molly, is just one of the sweetest people you'd ever want to meet in your entire life, and she introduced me to this song. I had never heard it before. It's called It's You I Like. It's a really just lovely song of affirmation and positivity and acceptance, which I think I learned it about 2 years ago, but I mean, we still need that now, I think. And so my eldest sister, Caitlin, she has a son, my nephew Arlo, who's just my lifeblood. He's 6 years old now, and I just love this kid so, so much. I spent the first about 5 years of his life with them living in the area, and then before they moved back to Wisconsin. But he loves music. He collected records when he was 2 years old, and tapes. He had his own tape deck, and he would go through his records and be like, Paul Simon, Townes Van Zandt. And he like knew all the record covers and the album names. And one time I babysat Arlo when he was 2 years old. And I was like, all right, buddy, before bedtime, you get to pick out two records. And he picked Battle of the Pink Robots by the Flaming Lips, which is my favorite Lips record. And he picked out a Cole Porter record from the 1920s, like a jazz record. And I was like, this is, you're so much cooler than I am. But anyways, all this to say, Arlo is just the neatest kid I've ever met in my life. I love him so much. And we play music together, too. I got him a drum set a few years ago for Christmas. And he's saying this is the only cover on the record that I put out around my head. It's the last song on the record. And Arlo actually recorded his vocals and sang this song with me on the album. So it's very special to me. And every time I sing it, I think about him. And his voice is just adorable. And, like, he was such a boss. I brought all these mics over, and he had, like, big studio headphones, and he was just, like cross-armed in the studio, 5 years old. I was like, this kid's a pro. So, anyways, this is always a good song to end things on, I think. So thank you to the Victoria House again for having us. Thank you so much. This has been a real treat for me, and such a nice night to close my tour. So thank you guys again. Please have those seafood recommendations ready for me I'm half joking. So anyways, this is It's You I Like, and in case you needed to hear it, you're very special and unique, and your weirdness should be embraced. Embrace your weirdness. It's you I like. It's not the things you wear, it's not the way you do your hair, but it's you I like. The way you are right now, the way deep down inside you, it's not the things that hide you, not your toy. They're just beside you. It's you I like. Every part of you, your skin, your eyes, your feelings, whether old or new. I hope that you'll remember when you're feeling blue. It's you I like. It's you yourself. It's you. I so much. This has been a real treat. Have a wonderful evening, and thanks again to our host.
Could we have another song, please?
Yeah, sure. If you guys want to hear one more song, sure, yeah. Yeah.
It's like if you're in the bar, like,
It is, yeah. Everyone should just been on stage, honestly. Yeah, sure. I'll share an original tune. This one's called St. Mary's Gospel Choir. I think this one is also a decent one to end on. We can have a lot of ending songs tonight. But as I mentioned, I come from a really, really small town in Wisconsin. I grew up in a pretty tight-knit Catholic community, and I don't practice anymore. But yeah, I grew up in this small town, and it was so connected. Just you'd see everybody, you know, one day of the week, and well, I guess pretty much every day of the week, but at church you'd go. And so anyways, I wrote this song. This is the oldest original tune that I still play. I wrote it about 10 years ago when I had moved west from my small town to Portland, Oregon. And yeah, I wrote this song about moving west and then coming actually back home and visiting for the first time and like kind of revisiting this place that made me the person that I am. And it was a very interesting experience because when I went back, I really didn't recognize myself in that place anymore. And that's a really strange feeling to return to, it could be a person, place, or thing that you are so once familiar with and just not really recognizing yourself in that thing anymore. And so that's very much what this song is about. But as it's grown with me over 10 years, and I've grown as a person and an artist and a strange human, it's, yeah, taken on different meaning. And for me, as this song has aged, it's definitely about the perspective thing. But for me, as someone who doesn't really practice the faith that I was raised on anymore, it's much more about, like, my relationship with the idea of God. And I think, at least in the community that I was raised in, it was a very specific way that you worshipped and, like, had held sacred space. And I think there's beauty to letting that relationship with whatever God is to you. It can change every morning when you wake up. And I think allowing yourself that freedom to change and grow is a really beautiful thing, and you should allow yourself that change and growth. So that's what this song's about, and it's called St. Mary's Gospel Choir.
I can't help myself when I'm around. So glad I found you, babe. My tender heart was crying. Cause living on the road, it can be lonely. Yeah, yeah, when you're only, babe. When you're only on your own. But do you remember when we were just children, robed in the gospel choir? I want you to sing for me again, sing hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Babe, don't wanna lose ya. Lose you once again. You and me playing in the fields of golden grain. Some old Wisconsin day, till we heard that bell toll. You take off with the north wind at your heels, back to your mama's porch. We're hiding waiting till after dark, when the moon was full. But do you remember that night in the graveyard? You kissed me on the lips and told me to sing for you again. Sing hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. babe, don't wanna lose you. Lose you once again.
So much. All right, well, hang out and we'll be hanging out now, so.
I'll do my like little crutch. Thank you for coming and live stream. I hope it pulled off well, and I hope you can hear, and I'm crouching over the mic, but I value the people that are on the live stream that are there and spending the time to listen. My dad's there, and Brandon, Kelly, Ian, and I know there's some other host of people that are just like lurking, or they'll come back and watch the show later because it has a 48-hour replay. So let's just remember that. That's cool. This is a good thing. But I think this is super. I knew it would sort of be a little rush to get things going today, but it just I could relax and just enjoy your music so much. So, thank you.
Thank you.
owls baked in solar flares, tinsel frost, clothesline cables and silvery pots in an old TV. No need for power, it had a good run. Oh, how these walls all laughs and cries. Holy Bible, wooden chair, burst on fire, lit it in swear. Everybody wants to be who they wish they really were. Game show pain, worn down, revealing the wooden remains of an old walkway. Pace back while the war's waged on. Come home, they pleaded, it's taking too long. Oh, how the shed saw laughs and cries. Holy Bible, wooden chair, burst on fire. They didn't swear. Everybody wants to be who they wish they really were. Who would they? Who would they now? Who would they now? It's been
there's this hole, the dark and frozen wide. And there's this beast that yearns to swallow.